Hello everyone and welcome to a new video. In this video we are featuring the match highlight of match number 3 of 4 match T20I international series between Team Scotland Women's and Team Ireland Women's played at the Stormont Cricket Ground in Belfast. And the update about the toss is that Team Ireland Women have won the toss and again they have elected to bat first against Team Scotland Women's. And now let's have a look at the playing 11 of both the team. First let's have a look at the Team Ireland. Then we have the captain of the team, Laura Denley, Eva Canning, Rachel Delaney, Shauna Kavanaugh, Gabba Lewis, Lara Maritz, Kira Murray, Leigh Paul, Ola Prendergast, Kirsten Rack and Rebecca Stokel in their playing 11. And now if we have a look at the playing 11 of Team Scotland Women's, then we have the captain of the team, Catherine Bryce, Sarah Bryce, Becky Glenn, Abby Atkin-Drummond, Aptasha Maksud and Ago, Kathy McGill, Prance Chatterjee, Ailsa Leister, Catherine Fraser and Megan McCall in their playing 11 for the third T20I international match. The positive intent of Team Ireland Women's is continuing from the very first ball in this match as they are trying putting pressure on Scotland Women team by hitting boundaries on consecutive basis, and they are batting really well and might take the total of Team Ireland to a good total after the power play overs. And here comes the first wicket for Scotland Women's team. The first wicket has been taken in the 6th over by Maksud, the wicket of Rebecca Stokel, who has been leg before wicket by Maksud on 16, and Scotland Women got the first wicket. Here comes another wicket for Team Scotland Women. This time it's the wicket of KB Lewis, who has been stumped by Bryce, bowled by Fraser on 16. And even after losing the wicket of KB Lewis, the positive intent in the batting from Ireland Women's continues as Delaney hits boundaries in the 9th over even after getting out before that delivery. What a scintillating bowling this has been from Maksud, who got the wicket of Laura Denley, who has batting extremely well for Team Ireland, but unfortunately she has been stumped again by Bryce, bowled by Maksud on 17, and two consecutive wickets are taken by Team Scotland Women's. It is a totally commendable performance from Team Scotland Women in this game as they got the wicket on regular interval. Another wicket has been gone down. This time it's the wicket of Ola Prendergast, who has been once again stumped by SJ Bryce, bowled by McCall this time on 10, and another wicket has been gone down of Team Ireland Women. And even in this over, one more wicket has been gone down. This time it's the wicket of Lara Maritz, who has been caught by Maksud, bowled by McCall on 8, and one more wicket has been gone down of Team Ireland Women's, and the Scotland Women team look pretty happy about their performance in this match. When the game seems to be slipped from the hand of Ireland Women's team and gradually going into the hand of Scotland Women's team, all thanks to their bowling performance, which seems to be the most amazing performance by Team Scotland Women's in this game after the first T20I match, that seems to be a wrap up the total of Ireland Women's team to a feasible total which can be chased by Scotland Women's team. There's a player named as Shauna Kavanaugh for Team Ireland Women's, who has the intent to swing the pendulum back in the favor of Ireland Women's team and to score a good amount of run that can be defendable. And she scored phenomenally well in 30 ball 37, and what a phenomenal batting she has been done for Team Ireland Women's as she makes sure that Team Ireland have posed a commendable total and that might can be defendable. And before departing in the 19th over, Shauna Kavanaugh on the score of 37 run makes sure that Team Ireland are in a stupendous situation as compared to Team Scotland Women, as they posted a total of 134 run with the loss of 8 wicket in their 20 over, which can be defendable and which is also good for fighting total. And now Team Scotland Women need 135 run to win this T20I match. And as Scotland Women start their chase of 135 run, and the first wicket also has been gone down, and this time it's the wicket of Becky Glenn, who has been bowled by Prendergast on a duck, and first wicket has been gone down for Team Scotland Women. One more wicket, this time it's the wicket of Sarah Bryce, and Prendergast got another wicket. This time she got the wicket of Sarah Bryce on 10 run, and another wicket has been gone down. Scintillating batting from Bryce, she hit boundaries on a consecutive manner. Some good amount of shots from Bryce for Team Scotland, and unless until another wicket has been gone down in the 10th over, Katie McGill has been caught by Canning, bowled by Paul on 17, and one more wicket has been gone down for Team Scotland. Poor performance of Scotland women team from the last T20I while chasing continues, as when they need to build up the partnership to chase down the total, they are kept losing wicket on regular interval. Another wicket has been gone down. This time it's the wicket of Matt Megan McCall, who has been caught by Murray, bowled by Paul on a duck, and another wicket has been gone down. Priyana Chatterjee has been bowled by Maris on 6, and when the poor performance still continues of Team Scotland women's team while chasing the total, when they need to build up partnership, hit boundaries, they are losing wicket on regular interval, and the grip of Ireland women team in the match are strengthening ball by ball. What a scintillating performance they have been putting against Scotland women team from the last game and also in this game. And that conclude the third T20I match. A drastic batting performance from Scotland women team make sure that Ireland women team won another match on a consecutive basis, as they won this match by 41 runs. A drastic performance by Scotland women team in batting led them to collapse on 93 runs in the response of 134 runs, and 135 runs is the target for Scotland women team, but they collapsed gradually and bowled out on 93 runs against 135 runs, and Ireland women team won this match easily by 41 runs and take a lead in the series.